friend Jack. Right now, it's Friday.
Fast. So how long do they think the meat on Arby's Smokehouse Brisket is smoked?
Maybe an hour? 2 hours? 3 hours?
What if I told you that Arby's Brisket is smoked for at least 13 hours?
That's long enough to smoke my meat.
It's going to be a munchetation situation.
Arby's tender brisket is smoked with hickory wood for at least 13 hours. The Smokehouse Brisket Sandwich. Freshly sliced in store and topped with melty smoked Gouda cheese. Craveable brisket, ready when you are. Arby's.
Slice the brisket.
I get the most amazing Mother's Day gift. It was a wonderful surprise.
This Mother's Day, surprise her with something different. Give Sherry's Berries the freshest, juiciest strawberries dipped in the finest ingredients. Choose from over 50 gourmet toppings, all delivered fresh to any home or office for Mother's Day.
When I opened the box, I was in heaven.
With this special offer, get a signature gift box of Sherry's Berries for just $19.99. And order now to double the berries for just $9.99 more.
I sent them to my mom. It was a really good deal.
Go to berries.com, click the mic in the upper right corner, and enter code SHOW. Get these amazing strawberries for just $19.99 or double the berries for only $9.99 more.
You can't go wrong sending a box of Sherry's Berries.
Berries.com. Click the mic and enter code SHOW or call 888-SWEET-90.
This is Weaver Cooks, and today we're doing chili cheese nachos. We start with a can of chili, open it up, and then the cheese sauce, we just take off the lid, and we pop these both in the microwave for 4.5 minutes. Things are done. We mix them both together, and this will run you about $6, but when you figure that it will feed anywhere from 3 to 6 people, it will only cost you $1 or $2 per person. And I'm Stephen Reed, and this was Weaver Cooks.
His secret ingredient is sadness. How that cheese sauce didn't boil over after 9 minutes in a microwave is the most remarkable thing I've ever seen. Seems like they're just giving away cooking shows to anyone nowadays. So I figured I'd make one for the fans I care about the most. Criminals. Yeah, believe it or not, I'm huge in the penal system. So this is for the incarcerated fans out there. Father, forgive me for living while my homie's stuck in prison. Hi, new fish. Welcome to Last Meal. Tonight, we're making a 2014 Pruno Grigio, a.k.a. toilet wine. Shut the fuck up! I'm doing a show!
You're gonna make me?
I will carve a new asshole into your throat, Espinoza. All right, let's get started. Here's what you'll need. Steal a plastic bag from the trash can in the yard. Next, you get yourself some bread, a couple pieces. Let it get nice and moldy for at least a week or so. 6 to 10 oranges. You're going to have to trade for them. The Mexicans control the oranges, just like they do on the outside. Let's see what I like to do afterwards. These make great makeshift. You just fish out of it. 4 packets of ketchup and or raisins. Next, I need 2 cans of fruit cocktail. This is where it gets a little tricky, okay? You're probably going to have to do some favors for someone on kitchen detail, most likely with your mouth. And finally, you'll need around 60 packs of sugar. That's a high-demand item in here, so be prepared to let many men inside of you. All the guys around here call me Sugar. Because I always need to borrow sugar, and I'm sweet. Mash up all the ingredients, okay? Hide in your toilet. There's a reason it's called toilet wine. Pour warm water over every day for 5 to 7 days. Where are you going to get warm water? Come on, guys. You got to pee on it. Luckily, we don't have to wait 5 to 7 days. I got a fresh batch ready to go. You're going to shank a hole in the bag, strain out the solids. Don't throw them away. That's 200 proof fruit salad. And that's how you drink in the clink. That's all the time we have this week. Next week, I'll be teaching you how to make the
loaf.
Treat. I've arranged a toilet wine tasting for the entire audience. Bottoms up, everyone. Swish around your palate and really let yourself experience the rancid bouquet. But whatever you do, please do not swallow it. Do not swallow it. If you guys think that's disgusting, you should have thought of that before you broke the law. Now, here's the viewer vine of the week.
Yeah, go around.
Be Gandalf for a second before he dies. We'll be right back with more Brick or Postcard.
Chicken Down. Introducing the new Chicken Big King with two